Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. The topic of this lesson is something that's been a source of frustration for me for a very long time, morphing shapes. Now, there are other tutorials out there that cover this, but I've come up with my own method and I wanted to share that with you. This lesson is going to run longer than 7 minutes, probably closer to 12 to 13, but if you stick around, it will be well worth the wait. Like I said, there are a host of tutorials out there about morphing shapes. All the ones I've come across are cumbersome, time-consuming, they require a lot of steps that just aren't effective, and few, if any, have consistent rules for this technique. Until now. There are a few rules that you need to remember, which I'll be displaying on screen as we get to them. I'll also put these rules in the description below. I recommend you watch this tutorial a few times to really get a solid hold of this technique. Once you understand the theory behind it, you'll be morphing shapes with ease. There's a lot to get through. So let's dive right in. Okay, so I brought in 3 shape layer icons. I'm going to show you how we can morph one into the next in a seamless way. So first, let's focus on just our headphones and our iPhone. We'll get rid of this laptop for now. Now, the key to doing this is to use a guide shape, and I'll show you what I mean by that. Let's go up to Layer, New, Shape Layer, and let's just add a rectangle and a fill. So now the way to conceptualize this process is you will always be going from one shape to another. So your first shape, consider that the animation out shape, and the second shape is your animation in. So this guide shape should match your animation in, which in this case is going to be the iPhone. So like to maybe about 2 seconds, and we'll pull that over and then we'll end our headphones there. There are a few things you need to pay attention to. The first one is the scale of the animation in. Our scale for this iPhone is at 53%. So let's make this shape layer 53% also, so that way it's identical to this one. We'll call this guide shape 1, and we'll even give it a different color. So let's just shape this so that way it looks like our iPhone. So we want to match as closely as possible. And if you bring up your opacity, you can kind of see. So this will be our guide shape for our first set of animations going into the iPhone. So the first rule is to use the shape that's being animated in as a reference for your guide shape. And we did that. So the second rule is you want to convert all shape paths to Bezier paths, unless the shape uses an animation tool. By animation tool, if you click on this add button, it means anything underneath gradient stroke. So anything merge paths, offset paths, all the way down to zigzag. If a group uses an animation tool, then you're not going to convert the shape to a Bezier path. And this will make more sense as we go through some of these, but for now, just keep that in mind that you want to convert all shapes to Bezier paths unless they use an animation tool. Right-click on rectangle path and convert to Bezier path. And that just gives us a path. So basically, when you do that, it converts a shape into a path. And if we want a path, we can put a keyframe for path and hit U on that layer, and let's hide that for now. So this is what's going to be driving the animation for this morphing sequence. Okay, so now let's open up our headphones because this is going to be our first shape or our animation out shape. And if we open up our earpiece, we see that we have 2 rectangle paths, no animation tool, meaning this doesn't have like a zigzag or a repeater or a merge paths or anything like that. So we can convert these both to Bezier paths. We'll put a keyframe for both of those and then close that up. And for outer earpiece, same thing. We have 2 rectangle paths we can convert with no animation tools. Go down to blue foam. We open that up. Now see, this does have a trim paths. So instead of converting to a Bezier path and morphing that shape, we're going to animate the trim paths. Just put a keyframe for end, close that back up. And for wire, we also have a trim paths, and we want to put a keyframe for end. And the reason why is because, as you can see, it has 56%. This is the percentage that's driving the animation. So that's what we're going to be animating. We can close that back up, and then let's go ahead and just put a keyframe for position and scale in case we need it. So now if you hit U on that layer, these are all of the keyframes that will be morphing into the guide shape, which is going to smoothly transition into our iPhone. Go down to the end of this layer here. Let's copy the keyframe from our guide shape. In any place you see path, just Control V to paste it. And then for these end percentages, make those 0. What we're trying to do is we're trying to make the last frame of the animation out or this headphones layer look identical to the beginning of this iPhone. And we will get there. But first, we need to prepare the iPhone for animation. Okay, so the next rule is you only want to morph large shapes using the guide path keyframe here. But for these smaller shapes, you want to animate the scale just because it makes it look much better. It's a much smoother transition. Like this speaker up here and this power button, we're going to be animating the scale of those groups. So let's open up speaker here and see this is a small shape. Put a keyframe for scale. Close that up. Power button's a small shape. So we want to put a keyframe for scale. Now our screen, we have a rectangle path, no animation tool, so no trim paths or anything. So convert to Bezier path, keyframe for path. And same thing for body. Right click, convert to Bezier path and keyframe for that. And then we're going to just put a keyframe for position and scale in case we need it. So let's hit U to bring up our keyframes. And so this is what this iPhone will eventually become. But we want it to start from this guide path here. So copy that keyframe. Where you see path, control V. And then for these scales up here for speaker and power button, make those values zero. So basically we want this shape to become this shape. And the way that we do that is, let's open up our headphones. If you hit U, we need our scales to match. So as you can see, our scale is different. See, we have 79.4. This scale is 53. So we want to animate the headphones. We want the final scale to be the same as the scale for our iPhone. So let's make that 53. And as we can see, it's the same size, but now they are off in position. So let's pull this over one frame so that way we can see this better. So basically we just need to move our headphones up so that way it matches it. And pull that frame back. And so we have this, which looks pretty smooth, but we still need to make a few more adjustments. Highlight all of the keyframes in the first set, keyframe assistant, ease out, graph editor, and let's just pull all these handles over. Maybe we'll even pull this a little bit closer. And then for the animation in, we're going to go keyframe assistant, ease in, and then pull all those handles over to the left. So now if we kind of watch this, we're almost there with this animation. We still need to make a few more adjustments. So the next rule is we need to animate the color of the animation out shape into the color of the animation in shape. See how this goes from this green and it pops right into that white? We want to animate that. Let's open up our headphones, and that color is coming from this earpiece here. So we open up our fill. We can see this is that green. Let's put a keyframe for that. And then we want that to fade into this color where the iPhone begins. And the way you do that is just grab the eyedropper, click that color, and hit U again, and make sure your keyframes are lined up, and they are. And we'll just go ahead and do the same thing to this animation color keyframe, make it a hard ease out. So it just makes this a little bit smoother. So that's morphing the headphone into the iPhone. So now let's morph our iPhone into our laptop. I'm gonna turn this on. We'll just come down here, maybe around 4 seconds. So now we need to make a guide shape for our laptop. Let's create a new shape layer, new shape layer, and we're gonna add a rectangle and give it a fill. And now remember, we need to make sure we have the same scale for our guide shape as we do for our laptop. So see, our laptop is at 53% scale. So we'll make this shape layer here 53% scale. And then open up our rectangle path and just adjust our size settings so it matches about the same size. So the size settings cover our screen from top to bottom. Just like that. Okay, and now right click, convert to Bezier path, put a keyframe for that and hit U. Then we'll hide that layer. So now we need to go to our iPhone and we need to animate that out to this new guide shape. So let's just highlight all of these keyframes, copy and paste. And if you right click with all of them highlighted, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes, it will just reverse the values. So see, now that goes back out to the shape. Right now it's going back to that first guide shape. So let's copy this keyframe from our new guide shape. And we're going to click on anything that has path and control V. So now that will become the wider rectangle. And we need to prep our laptop shape for animation. So let's open that up. So our reflection path here, this has a trim paths. So we're not going to be morphing this group. Instead, we're going to animate the trim paths. So put a keyframe for N because that's the percentage that's being animated at 100%. And then let's open up our speaker. And now this is a small shape. We just make the solo this. So this is our speaker, this like little shape right here. So that's a small shape. So we'll be animating the scale of that instead of morphing it. The keyboard. We have a merge paths, so we'll be animating the scale of that group. And now our screen is a rectangle path with no animation tool. So convert to Bezier, keyframe for path, same for body, convert to Bezier, and then the keyframe for that path. Now let's hit U, and let's go ahead and line up all these keyframes here. If you hold down shift and hit P and S, it brings up your position and scale. I like to always add in those keyframes just in case we need them. Okay, so let's go back to the beginning of that layer. Let's go back up to our guide shape and hit U. Copy that keyframe, and again, wherever we see path, we're going to control V. And then for this trim pass, we're going to make that 0. For scale, make that 0. And for this scale, this is the keyboard. So let's just make this first value 0. So that way it animates from the center. So now remember, we need to line up these two shapes here. This is our final rectangle. Let's just move laptop above iPhone so we can see it better. And then so we need to move now our position up so that way these two match. And we want to highlight the second set of keyframes, ease in, keyframe assistant. We're going to pull all those over. So just see how this is looking real quick. So that's basically the idea right there. Okay, and then we just need to animate now the color of this screen. So if we open this up, our iPhone screen goes into our laptop screen. So remember, we need to make a keyframe for this color here. And then we want to take our eyedropper and choose this gray. So that way, as it animates out, it goes from white into gray. And again, the rules are as follows. You want to use the shape that's being animated in as a reference for the guide shape. Remember, you have an animation out shape and an animation in shape. Whenever you're creating your guide shapes, make sure that you pay attention to the scale of the guide shape and the shape that you're making the guide shape for. They should have the same exact scale. Convert all shape paths to Bezier paths, unless that shape is using an animation tool, such as trim paths, merge paths, zigzag, etc. When a path uses trim paths, don't morph the shape. Instead, you want to animate the trim paths. When a group uses any other animation tool, such as repeater or merge paths, don't morph the shape. Instead, animate the group's scale. The next rule is you want to morph large shapes only using the path of the guide shape. You want to animate the scale of small shapes. So whenever you have a small shape like a power button or a tiny speaker, don't morph that, but instead animate the scale of that group. Next, you want to make sure that you animate the color of the animation out object to the color of the shape that's being animated in. Finally, in between animations, you just want to make sure that you line up your animation out shape with your animation in shape. The main thing you want to accomplish is you want the final frame of the animation out shape to look identical to the first frame of the animation in shape. I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And don't forget to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. I put the project file in the description below along with a link to my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. Would love to see you guys over there and teach you all about shape layers. Feel free to reach out to me anytime with any questions or comments, and let me know what topic you'd like to see covered. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you next time.